In this video, we're going to work on problem 1.4.5 from the textbook. Prove that for any real numbers x and y, the absolute value of the absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y is less than or equal to the absolute value of x minus y. Before solving the problem, let me introduce some important results. Let m be a non-negative number, then the absolute value of a is less than or equal to m if and only if a is greater than or equal to minus m and less than or equal to m. Now, note that a is greater than or equal to minus m if and only if minus a is less than or equal to m. Therefore, this inequality can be written as a is less than or equal to m and minus a is less than or equal to m. Therefore, in order to prove that the absolute value of a is less than or equal to m, we can show that a is less than or equal to m and minus a is less than or equal to m. Okay? Now, another important result we're going to use is the triangle inequality. For any real numbers a and b, the absolute value of a plus b is less than or equal to the absolute value of a plus the absolute value of b. Therefore, the approach we're going to use in order to solve this problem is as follows. Now, this is a non-negative real number n. So in order to prove that the absolute value of this number a is less than or equal to m, we're going to show that a is less than or equal to m, and at the same time, minus a is less than or equal to m. Okay, so let me go ahead and apply the triangle inequality to prove the inequality. By the triangle inequality, we have the following. The absolute value of x is the same as the absolute value of x minus y plus y, and is less than or equal to the absolute value of x minus y plus the absolute value of y. So here we apply the triangle inequality for a and b, where a is equal to x minus y and b is equal to y. Okay? Thus, from here, if we subtract both the sides by the absolute value of y, then we get this. The absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y is less than or equal to the absolute value of x minus y. Okay? Now, let's continue by proving that minus a here is also less than or equal to this number m. Okay, so this is a. A is the absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y. We have showed that a is less than or equal to m. In order to complete the proof, we also need to show that minus a is less than or equal to m. And note that minus a here is equal to the absolute value of y minus the absolute value of m. Okay, so again, by the triangle inequality, we have the following. So similarly, the absolute value of y is equal to the absolute value of y minus x plus x. Okay. And now here, if we apply the triangle inequality for a and b, this is less than or equal to the absolute value of y minus x plus the absolute value of x. Okay. And note that the absolute value of y minus x is equal to the absolute value of x minus y. So this is just the absolute value of x minus y plus the absolute value of x. At this point, we can subtract both sides by the absolute value of x and get this. The absolute value of y minus the absolute value of x is less than or equal to the absolute value of x minus y. Now, we have showed that a here is less than or equal to m, and then minus a is also less than or equal to m. Therefore, the absolute value of a, that is the absolute value of
the absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y is less than or equal to m, that is the absolute value of x minus y. So we have completed the proof of the inequality. So we have used the triangle inequality to prove this useful inequality. And note that we can derive two other inequalities from this inequality. Note that we always have that A is less than or equal to the absolute value of A. That means a number is less than or equal to its absolute value. At the same time, minus A is also less than or equal to the absolute value of A. Now, from here, note that this number is less than or equal to its absolute value. So we have this. The absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y is less than or equal to the absolute value of the absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y, and therefore it is less than or equal to the absolute value of x minus y. And here this is the absolute value of y minus the absolute value of x, that is minus a, where a is the absolute value of x minus the absolute value of y, and therefore we get this inequality. The absolute value of y minus the absolute value of x is also less than or equal to this absolute value, and it is less than or equal to the absolute value of x minus y. These are very, very useful inequalities that we are going to use later. So in this video, we have proved this inequality using the triangle inequality, and then we derive two other inequalities based on this inequality.